Should we do a really quick ASMR of drinking water? I've never done one of these.
Hey guys. Hello guys. Today I've been drinking some water. I'm about to take a sip of the water. Thank you for watching this ASMR. Welcome to today's video.
Rip headphone users.
Hello guys, my name is Dan and welcome back to another, drumroll, Infinite Flight video. Yeah! Basically, as you guys already know, there is buildings, you know, terminals and clouds coming to Infinite Flight at some point in the future. Who knows when it's ready, apparently. I'm not going to waffle the intro. Basically, Infinite Flight released this article featuring a lot of frequently asked questions, which I'm going to go ahead and basically explain and read out in this video, which will save you guys reading through it yourself, I guess. I usually do this with all the Infinite Flight updates, so if you're new around here, subscribe. I'd also just like to point out that it's worthwhile noting that every single thing I mention in this video is 100% true. It's official information, so I'm not speculating anything in this video. So, let's jump into it. Are buildings the airport or also cities? And I mean, the short answer which they've said to this is buildings will only be at airports with the release of this update, which is understandable. Do you guys want some lag? No, not really. Who wants lag? Now, the next one kind of confused me as to why people would ask about this, because it's a bit strange. There'd definitely be a lot of trolls out there, especially not doing things very accurately. Will building placement be auto-generated or placed manually? If manual, will users have an opportunity to construct airports? Their answer to this question was, airport buildings are a mix of generated and handcrafted models. I think it says, I know exactly what it says, I just struggle to pronounce it. They said that they're building tools to make it easy to create complex airports quickly, but they'll remain internal for now. So basically what they're saying is that nobody can just create these airports. They are going to be the ones to solely make these airports for us to fly in and out of. They're using OpenStreetMap data to get an initial building footprint to start from. Objects are placed by hand and they'll provide more information on this in a future post. So yeah, we're going to see a lot more to do with buildings basically in the future before it comes. Next question, how many objects will there be at each airport? And they said that this depends on each airport and the level of performance they are looking to achieve. Why has the camera suddenly gone out of focus? Now, the next one we're going to talk about is slightly disappointing, but how many airports will actually have buildings and where will they be? And they said that on release, they'll only have a handful of airports so that they can ensure that it works well before we start scaling to more. So, I mean, it's logical, like it makes sense, but we're only going to have a handful of airports with buildings initially. And I mean, you could imagine there'd be airports such as, and I mean, I did say all of the information that would be accurate in this video. Let's just, but let's just use our imagination very quickly and believe that it will be airports such as Heathrow, LAX, you know, the JFK, maybe, I don't know, but like the most common and famous airports will probably have buildings because they're going to be, you know, the most frequently used airports are most likely going to have the 3D buildings, right? That makes perfect sense. Honestly, I absolutely highly doubt that with the release of this, there'll be like small little airfields of buildings. I don't think that'll be a thing until the future. I mean, I could be completely wrong, but I don't see an airfield coming with a hangar over an international airport, to be honest. Okay, so the next one, will buildings have unique details such as logos, decals, and company names? And then they quickly basically summarize this in the most shortest way possible, not in the initial release, but this is something that they are considering. Now, I'd assume that to use companies' logos and branding and stuff like that, they'll need permission, most likely. I'm not entirely sure how that works. They might not actually need the permission. But just to put a few examples on the screen right now, this is basically what this question means, and I'm 100% you guys know exactly what they're talking about. The next one is also very short and simple. Will the buildings have collision detection? We have no plans for the collision detection at the moment. Bang, simple as that. Moving on. The next one I feel like is a really important aspect to realism, and you guys are most likely going to agree with me on this one, but will objects such as jet bridges and vehicles be animated? And here's the answer to that one. Many objects showed in the recap video have animations. Yes! Let's celebrate! They have animations! Ted just doesn't care. Look at him. All you have to do is look at him and he starts wagging his tail. Look away, look, he stops wagging his tail a little bit. Stop wagging your tail. I'm trying to record now. Stop smacking the bed with your tail. So many objects showed in the recap video have animations, but, big but, the first release of buildings and terminals will most likely have static objects, which basically means, if you don't know what static means, I'll be surprised if you don't. It basically means they won't do anything. They'll be fixed in a position and they will not move. They'll just be sitting there. Static. This is simply so they can ensure a high level of performance before adding more functionality. Again, that's very understandable. If you guys don't want lag, then you're gonna have to let them optimize it prior to adding a shitload of stuff, basically. Okay, now the next one. Will the buildings and objects interact with the environment? Yeah, because the building, the terminal, is just going to grow a pair of arms and legs and start walking off, isn't it? Yeah. No, I'm joking. Let's go into a little bit of detail. Their goal is to have objects such as wind stocks. If you don't know what a wind stock is, this is a... I was out of frame there. This is a wind stock. And their goal is to actually animate this based on the actual wind conditions, which again would make sense. If it didn't, then it would just be absolutely ridiculous. There'd be no point in having wind stocks because... they're there to show the wind. Other items such as radars and beacons will animate automatically as we are able to add those items. This may not come in the first release. Again, not a lot of stuff is coming in the first release. We're going to see a lot of static things in the first release solely for performance. But I mean, you can't complain. Buildings, that they're literally... why would you complain? If you complain, then... I don't know. Okay, now the next question is one that I actually really like, and I do support this one a lot. Will non-pro subscribers have buildings too? And the simple answer to this is yes, okay? Non-pro subscribers will have access to buildings that are available in the regions that they are able to fly in with the initial purchase of the app. The next one's quite funny, actually. Will the subscription price increase when airport buildings and the clouds are released? The answer to this, well, no. Okay, the next one's one that many of you might be interested in. How will my device handle the new features? Now, this is one, yeah, that you'll definitely be wondering about. They said that they are working hard to ensure that everyone can enjoy this new content. Quality settings will allow users to reduce the number of objects at the airport. To reduce the number of airport objects visible to adapt to their... Quality settings will allow users to reduce the numbers of objects... Oh! Damn it! Quality settings will allow users to reduce the numbers of airport objects visible to adapt to their device performance. Yes, we said it all at once. We done it. Subscribe. Please, Ted, I'm trying to record. Please stop smacking the bed of your tail. Like, allow me to record, please. Thanks. Okay, the next one. Are the buildings streamed like the scenery? Will this impact my data usage? So the short answer to that is yes, it will be streamed like the scenery, but it will have a very minimal impact on your data usage for now. Dun, dun, dun. Project Metal. This is what we've all been talking about for absolutely ages. How does Project Metal influence buildings? Are buildings a part of Project Metal? Here we go. This is the answer we've been waiting for. I think. Hopefully, I haven't actually read this yet, so we'll see. So they went ahead and said that Project Metal is our effort to modernize our low-level graphics engine. We made great progress in the first half of 2020, but then hit a few roadblocks. This then required them to change a few things in Infinite Flight to help them with integrating Project Metal improvements. Buildings are helping us do that. So yeah, I think that means that buildings will also come with Project Metal. Project Metal will support these upcoming updates. Obviously, why wouldn't it? Next one's actually really interesting. How long have you been working on buildings? The integration of buildings has been in the works since late 2019. Would you believe that? 2019. That's quite a while, actually. Okay, now this is one that they're unsure of. Are clouds and buildings coming at the same time? This is something that they are not sure of yet. They will communicate as soon as they are able to. So they'll let us know as soon as they can. They're both not fully ready. So, you know, there's not really a straightforward answer for that one. Now, this is a good one. This obviously goes along with the live weather, which we do currently have in Infinite Flight. Will the clouds be updated in real time? And they went ahead and said that their intention for clouds is to be synchronized with the live weather when online. So there's the short answer to that one. The next one, are clouds 2D or 3D? I mean, this is one that quite a few of us have probably known already, but they went ahead and said that they will simulate a thin layer of cirrus clouds in version 1. They then plan to experiment with multiple layers of 3D clouds in the future. So we will see 3D clouds in the future, but it's probably quite a while away. Now, the last question which was asked was, does this mean that new lighting will be coming? Obviously, there's been a lot of speculation with Project Metal, how powerful it is, lighting, clouds, buildings. I mean, quite a lot of that stuff's true now, right? But will new lighting come? Now, they've gone ahead and said dynamic aircraft and taxiway lighting is something that they desperately want to add, but they are currently limited by our aging graphics technology. They will refocus on this after the first release of buildings. This will be another step in Project Metal. Now, if you guys want me to read this as well, I will go ahead and read it. There's probably no point in me reading this. I'm now rapping like Eminem, but there's no, let's just carry on. As you may have started to notice, and if you guys don't know what Project Metal is, this is basically a quick summary. Project Metal is something that allows Infinite Flight to evolve and improve over time. As their team updates the graphics pipeline, more features such as dynamic lighting will be possible. So initially, just expect maybe clouds. They don't really know. I mean, there's no release date for both of these. They could, this is not true, but they could come at the same time, but they could also not. I'm not gonna say, yeah, they're coming in 3 months, because no one knows that, okay? No one knows that. Guys, that's been another Infinite Flight update video. Thank you so much for watching. If you're new around here, please consider subscribing. If you haven't already liked this video, make sure you go ahead and do so. And yes, with that being said, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in my next video.